After being slashed in the Senate, the highly criticized confidential fund of the Philippine Education Department backed to 150 million pesos in the bicameral panel's version of the proposed 2023 budget. The spending plan for the controversial anti-insurgency task force, well, that's also restored back to 10 billion pesos. Meanwhile, former President Gloria Arroyo is backing the proposed creation of a sovereign wealth fund. Our very own RG Cruz now joins us with details. RG, good afternoon. Over to you.
Good afternoon, Carmina. The bicameral conference committee on the disagreeing provisions of the Senate and House versions of the 2023 national budget wrapped up its work earlier today with the signing of the committee report that finalizes the budget in time for the expected transmittals of the president before the end of the month. Of course, what's going to happen after this morning is that the committee report will be signed and it will be transmitted back to both chambers for plenary ratification, after which the budget can be printed for the president's signature. Of course, printing takes a few weeks, roughly around 2 weeks, because of the volume of documents that need to be printed for the budget. Now, what's in the committee report? Of course, you already heard from the chairman of the bicameral panel, the controversial budgets of the confidential fund of the Department of Education restored to 150 million despite the realignments made by the Senate. And of course, the budget of the National Task Force to End Local Communist Armed Conflict restored to 10 billion, which was also affected by institutional realignments made by the chambers in their respective versions. Of course, the meeting of the bicameral panel was also an opportunity for presidential son, Ilocos Norte Representative Sandro Marcos, to come to the defense of his proposal, which he proposed alongside his uncle, Speaker Martin Romualdez, which is, of course, the creation of the Maharlika Wealth Fund. So let's listen into their statements from the bicameral meeting.
Sabi nila is they need that budget. So yun ang, siyempre nirespeto natin yung wishes ng agency.
It's a decision of the House, the leadership na ituloy, no? Kasi mahirap mga kabataan natin na re-recruit sa maling papuntang landas. We want them to be secured the future of our children.
Hahawakan yung pension ng ating mga kababayan. I think that might have been just a misunderstanding or maybe it was political. The whole point of this, and you can see naman, it's been politicized, but the whole point of this is that it is free from politics. It will be run like a private corporation, hopefully by technocrats that know what they're doing, to be able to make sure that the government's money is used properly and invested the right way. Yes, the president will be chairman of the board, but that's this. You have to look at it beyond this administration.
And that was the latest from the committee hearing. Back to you, Carmina.
All right, Archie, I also saw a tweet that former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo also endorsing this proposal to have a sovereign wealth fund. Can you tell us more about that?
Yeah, that was a statement that she sent, or her office sent earlier today. Let me just retrieve it. In that statement, she reminds the public that this proposal, this idea of a sovereign wealth fund for the country was not new. In fact, Representative Marcos also talked about it during that interview that we had with him earlier, that this was a bill that was filed in 2016 by a member of the, now the opposition, former Senator Bam Aquino. And of course, former President Arroyo is also talking about how the success of any fund lies in the quality of its management. And she's saying that, having the president chair the governing board is a powerful statement that the highest official of the land will be accountable to the Filipino people for the performance of the fund. And she also talked about the various mechanisms that will protect the seed money or that come from the various investable funds of the government financial institutions. Of course, Representative Arroyo is a senior deputy speaker and a member of the House leadership, so she is really endorsing this bill which is expected to undergo public consultation later today here at the House of Representatives. They are also hoping that the House at least will be able to approve this on final reading before it goes on its Christmas recess, which is about next week.
Thanks a lot, RJ Cruz there, joining us on the line.